casino.
He is very nearby, but he was not 3 leagues off when I left him.
How many gentlemen have you lost in this action?
But few of any sort, and none of name.
A victory is twice itself when the achiever brings home full numbers. I find that Dom Peter hath bestowed much honor on a young Florentine called Claudio.
Much deserved on his part, and equally remembered by Don Pedro. He hath indeed borne himself beyond the promise of his years to make in the figure of a lamb, the face of a lion. He hath indeed bettered expectation than you must expect of me to tell you how.
He hath an uncle here, Messina, will be very much glad of it.
I have already delivered his letters, and there appears much joy in them. So much joy that could not show itself without a badge of bitterness.
Did he break out into tears?
In great measure.
A kind overflow of kindness. There are no faces truer than those that are so washed. How much better it is to weep in joy than to joy in weeping.
I pray you, is Signor Mantalto returned from these wars or no? I know none of that name, lady. There is none such in the army of any sort.
What is he that you ask for, niece?
My cousin means Signor Benedict of Padua.
Oh, he is returned, and as pleasant as ever he was.
He set up his bills here in Messina and challenged Cupid at the flight.
And my uncle's fool, subscribing for Cupid, challenged him on the bird boat. But I pray you, how many hath he killed and eaten in these wars?
He hath done good service then in these wars, lady.
You had musty victual he hath hold to eat it. He's a very valiant trencherman. He hath an excellent stomach.
And a good soldier, too, lady.
A good soldier, too, a lady.
But what is he to a lord?
A lord to a lord, and a man to a man, stuffed with all honorable virtues.
It is so indeed. He is no less than a stuffed man.
But for the stuffing, well,
Faith, please, you have seen your Benedict too much, but he'll be neat with you. I can assure you that. Mistake, my niece. You see, there's a kind of merry warmth to Senior Bennett and her. They never meet. There's a skirmish of wit between them.
Alas, he gets nothing by that. In our last conflict, 4 of his 5 wits went halting off. So now is the whole man governed with one. That if he have wit enough to keep himself warm, let him bear it for a difference between himself and his horse. It is all the wealth that he hath left to be known for a reasonable creature.
I pray you, who is his companion?
He hath every month a new sworn brother.
Is it possible?
Very easily so. He wears his faith but as a fashion of his hat, and changes with the next walk.
I see, lady, the gentleman is not in your books.
No! And he were, I would burn my study.
But I pray you, who is his companion? Is there no young swearer now that will make a voyage with him to the devil?
He is most in the company of right noble Claudio.
Lord, he will hang upon him like a disease. He is sooner caught than the pestilence, and the taker runs presently mad.
God help the noble Claudio.
If he have caught the Benedict, it'll cost him £1,000 ere he be cured.
I will hold friends with you, lady.
Do good friends. You will never run mad, niece.
No, not till a hot January. Don Pedro has approached.
Good Signora Leonardo, why are you come to meet your trouble? The fashion of the world is to avoid cost, and you encounter it.
Never came trouble to my house in the likeness of your grace. Your joy be gone, how would you obey? Only to call me, sorrow abides in happiness tastes leave.
You embrace your charge too willingly.
I think this is your daughter.
Your mother hath many times told me so.
Were you in doubt, sir, that you asked her?
Signor Benedict, no, for then were you a child.
We may guess by this what you are, Signor Benedict. Being a man, but truly the lady fathers herself. Be happy, lady, for you are like an honorable father.
If Leonardo be her father, she would not have just held her shoulders for all Messina's life as she is.
I wonder that you will still be talking, Signor Benedict. Nobody marks you.
My dear Lady Disdain, are you yet living?
Is it possible Disdain to die while she has such meat food to feed it as Signor Benedict? Courtesy itself must convert to disdain if you come in her presence.
Then is courtesy a turncoat, for it is certain I am loved of all ladies, only you excepted. And I would have confided in my heart, though I am not a hard heart, for truly I love none.
A dear happiness to women, else it would have been trouble for the pernicious suitor. I thank God in my cold blood I am of your humor for that. I'd rather hear my dog bark than crow.
But I'm not scared, he loves me.
Well, God keep your ladyship still in that mind, so that some gentleman or other escape a predestined scratched face.
Scratch cannot make it worse, and were such a face as yours were.
Why, you are a rare parent, teacher.
A bird of my tongue is better than a beast of yours.
I would my horse had the speed of your tongue and so good a continuer, but keep your way in God's favor.
You always end with the jade's trick. I know you of old.
Senior Benedict, Senior Claudio, I have told Leonardo that we shall be alive at least a month, and he but begs that some occasion may detain us longer. I dare swear he is no hypocrite, but praise from his heart.
If you swear, my lord, you shall not be forsworn. We bid you welcome. Being reconciled to the prince, your brother, I owe you all duty.
I thank you. I am not to have many words, but I thank you.
Is it your bracelet on?
Your hand in mine. We will go together.
Senior Benedict, didst thou note the daughter of Signor Leonardo?
I noted her not, but I looked on her.
Is she not a modest young lady?
Do you ask me, as an honest man should do, for my simple, true judgment, or would you have me speak after my custom as being a professed tyrant to their sex?
No, I pray thee, speak in sober judgment.
Well, in faith, you think she's too low for a high praise, too brown for a fair praise, or too little for a great praise? Only this combination I can afford her, that being other than as she was, she were unhandsome, but being other than as she is, I don't like her.
Thou thinkest I am in sport. I pray thee, tell me truly how thou likest her.
Would you buy her that you inquire after her thus?
Can the world buy such a jewel?
Yea, a case to put it into.
In mine eye, she's the sweetest lady I ever looked on.
I see yet without spectacles, and I see no such matter. But there's her cousin, and were she not possessed with a fury, doth exceed her as much in beauty as the first day of May doth the last in December. But surely you're not trying to turn husband, are you?
I would scarce trust myself, though I'd sworn otherwise. If Hera would be my wife.
Does it come to this? Hath the world not one man who will wear his cap with suspicion? Will I never see a bachelor of threescore again? But go to, in faith, thrust thy neck into a yoke, wear the print of it, and sigh away Sundays. Oh, Pompey.
What secret hath kept you here that you followed not to Leonardo's?
I would your grace would constrain me to tell.
I charge thee on my allegiance.
Mark me this, Claudio, I can be as secret as a dumb man, but on my allegiance. He's in love. Now, with who? That is your grace's part. Mark how short his answer is. With Hero, Leonardo's short daughter.
If it were so, so were it utter.
Aye, let the old tale, my lord. It is not so, nor twas not so, but God forbid it should be so.
And if my passions change not shortly, God forbid it should be otherwise.
Amen. If you love her for the lady, it is very well worthy.
Thou speakest to fetch me in, my lord.
By my troth, I spoke my thought.
And in faith, my lord, I spoke mine.
And by my two troths and faiths, I spoke mine.
That I love her, I feel.
That she is worthy, I know.
That I neither feel how she could be loved, or know how she should be worthy, is the opinion that fire cannot melt out of me. I will die with that at the stake.
Thou wast ever an obstinate heretic, in despite of beauty.
And never could maintain his part, but enforce his will.
That woman conceived me, I thank her. And that she reared me up, I likewise give her most humble thanks. But that I should have a reachy wind in my forehead, or hang my bugle on an invisible baldric, all women shall pardon me. And so I will not do them the wrong to trust any, I will do myself the right to trust none. And the fine is, for which I may look the finer, I will have a passion.
I will see thee, ere I die, look pale with love.
With anger, with sickness, or with hunger, my lord, not with love. Prove that ever I lost more blood with love than I could get again by drinking, and pluck out mine eyes with a bowmaker's pen, and hang me up at the door of a brothel house with a sign of blind Cupid.
Well, as time shall fly, in time the savage bull doth bear thee you.
The savage bull may, but if ever the sensible Benedict doth bear it, have the bull's horns plucked out and lend them in my forehead, and in the manner that they write, here is good horse for hire, let them signify under my sign, here is Benedict, the merry man.
Well, you temporize with the hours. In the meantime, good Signor Benedict, prepare to Leonardo's, commend me to him, and tell him I shall not fail him at supper, for indeed he hath made great preparation.
I have just enough matter in me for an emissage, and so I must.
My liege, your highness may now do me good.
My love is thine to teach. Teach it but half.
Hath Leonardo any...